Hello everyone. Today I want to share our Toyota Sienna mini camper van conversion. This is a 2020 model, which is basically the same from 2011 to 2020 model years. There will be an all new 2021 model. However, when we learned that the newer model will not have a removable second seat, and also the interior volume will be quite smaller, so we decided to stick with the current model. Based on our own needs and abilities, we focus on a simple conversion. So our focus is to have good sitting and a sleeping area, as well as much storage area as possible. Okay, now let's take a look at the inside. This is a common wood frame, a box, plus foam mattress conversion. To start conversion, I first removed the second and the third row seats. I followed the idea of box frame from Bruce Parks. His approach of anchoring the box frame to the vehicle floor using hose clamps is brilliant. There will be another removable extension piece at the front, so the total length at around 75 inches. Good enough for us. This is what it looks like when finished. With mattress on top, we have two 25-inch mattresses in parallel. The purpose of having two pieces is to make access storage area easier, either from inside or from outside. To access the storage area from inside, it's very easy. We just lift it up. So this will be the first one. And if we want to get access to the second one, it's right over here, okay? As you can see, that's why we pick two-piece mattress in parallel to make things everything is easier. Okay. Another thing is we designed the height of our bed or the box frame plus the mattress such that when we sit, our head will not hit the roof. So it's quite comfortable sitting inside. Now, also, I installed two vertical bars. One is on the right hand side and the other one is on the left hand side. So with this one, I can hang up some little things, hat or something, and we can put our LED light on top of that. And with this one, I can also put LED light, or right here is a small portable fan to help the air circulation inside. Early on in the conversion, we decided to have a floor in this heavy traffic area. I put 3/8 plywood to level the seat rail height. The floor is 1/2 inch plywood with vinyl on top. Now let's take a look from the back. Okay, to access the back storage area, we just lift it, fold it like this, and we lift it up. I have two simple hooks. Okay. Now this area is for water container, a mini fridge, 12 volt DC fridge. You can open like this. Okay. And storage for all the kitchen stuff. Kitchen, cooking ingredient, food, pots and pans, and the portable stove. Okay. And we also have a simple this manual faucet. So instead of lifting the water container out for using every time, I can just help with this faucet, manual faucet. Okay. Now, when I put it down, I can slide this open. Okay. Now this area we can use for washing, for cooking or eating. And of course, if you have a picnic table nearby, you can use the picnic table. But if you want to get under the shade or the weather is not cooperating, this is a very convenient table for you to use. Okay. Yeah. So when you finish, you just slide it in. And we have a hook just to lock it. Okay. Yeah. So this is the back storage area when it's done. As I mentioned before, we have a 14-inch extension, removable extension at the front. Okay. So just this one and this one. So this is a removable extension, so we can. Now, I have four longer legs. I can remove those short legs and replace with a longer leg. In case I need to have a table inside, I can put this one as a table right here and to sit here, okay? To provide the DC power supply, I got a simple solution, just to use a jackery battery power. So this is a Jackery 1000, and I use this one to provide power to our mini fridge. It's 12 volt. I can put it here, and it has the AC plug. I can charge my camera battery, and also have USB-C and USB charger. So it provides the light and also all the portable electronics charging. So that's the DC power. Okay. Now, to charge this battery, when I drive, I use the cigarette lighter, this 12 volt from the car, to charge, or I can charge using a solar panel. Okay. So, put it back here. Okay. That's pretty much all about our Sienna mini camper van conversion. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comments. Thank you for watching. Bye.